Morena everyone. My name is Ilse Kreis and I represent Western Bay of Plenty District Council here today. I'm going to have a little bit of a chat to you about what we do for waste minimisation and how we are doing these plans and programs to protect our environment. So I'm going to show you a few slides and then hopefully afterwards you can come and have a look at our desk and come and win a competition as well. And this is taking a little bit longer than I thought. Okay, so I'm going to start off by telling you about recycling. We've got three recycle centres in the Western Bay. We've got one green waste drop-off. And for those of you that have visited the Te Puke Recycling Centre, you will know what we take down there. It's basically all our glass bottles and jars. It is plastics number one and two. We take used motor oil. We take batteries, car batteries. And we've also started a battery recycling trial now for dry cell batteries. For those of you that don't know our other recycle centres, if you're just living in Te Puke and never travel somewhere, this is the Athenry Recycling Centre from the air. It is built on a closed landfill. It used to be a landfill many years ago. And now we are using it as a recycle centre. So it works on the same principle as the one in Te Puke. So if ever you're in that vicinity, or you're having a holiday in Waiea Beach, come around, come and have a look. Come to Athenry and a good team will meet you there to take your recyclables. Our other recycling centre is actually in Kadi Kadi. This centre has got enormous amount of traffic through it. Our level of service there is that we only open for 3 hours on a opening day, on a Sunday and on a Thursday, so we get about 400 vehicles through in those 3 hours. So you can imagine, and I think the Kadi Kadi people are quite good recyclers. So that's the centre from the air. We take all our glass that goes to up to Auckland. We bale our cardboard. We bale our plastics. We bale our aluminium, and that goes to Metalco that recycle all our metals from the recycle centre. And then we've got a green waste drop-off in Omokoroa. Now this one at the moment is going to disappear because there's a housing accord and there's houses being built at the back of this area. So where you see that pad there, that's basically the whole operation. People come and drop off their green waste. And we, in our WMMP at the moment, that's the Waste Minimisation Management Plan, we are looking at where we're going to re-establish this green waste centre and maybe have a recycle centre for Omokoroa as well as the district is growing. And then the one that you all should know and that you all should frequent and that you all should know Varinia and her team is the Te Puke Recycle Centre. It's the one here on Station Road, if you don't know where it is, just on Station Road. They're open today till 4 o'clock. Very busy, very nice little modern centre. Go and meet the team out there. They'll take your green waste, they'll take your plastics, your bottles, and they'll even have a little bit of a chat for you. I'm sure you've met them out there. So, we've recently had a spate of burglaries in there, so if you know about the culprits who's doing that, come and talk to me afterwards. So I just wanted to give you some figures of what we've avoided going to landfill by having these three recycle centres in the district. So look at that, look at those numbers. 687 tonnes of colour sorted glass. We've collected that, they didn't go to landfill, it was recycled. But look at the bottom, I'm sure you don't know about that one. 980 tonnes of sludge that comes from the Te Puke and the Makatu wastewater treatment plant didn't go to landfill. We actually vermicomposted that. So that's great. There's still wastewater treatment plants in the country that actually sends that to landfill. But we've gone and we've done the right thing for that. Our programs that I'd like to introduce is for waste minimisation is we've got a free business waste minimisation program. And I'm not going to read all of that there, but if you sign up for that, which by the way is a free service to you as a business, this person, Mr. Marty Hoffert from Waste Watchers, he will come in and he will come and slim your bin. It's not Weight Watchers, but Waste Watchers. So what he will do is he will come and do an audit for you. He will look at your disposal costs at the moment and see how we can get that down. and it will increase your recycling rates. So you may ask what's involved in a waste audit. Well, there's some photos up there of one that we've done at Comvita a year or so ago. So basically they go through all your skips, all your rubbish bins, and they actually sort what can be recycled, what can be reused, and in the end we just look at what is residual waste. And then what they do is they make some recommendations. You don't need to actually implement all the recommendations, but what it will be helpful for you that you will cut your waste bill if you do implement it. So if you know someone that's got a business, get them to come and give me a call or write your name down, then I'll get Marty to contact you. I thought we would just showcase what we've done. These are the bigger ones that we've done, and they've agreed to a case study. So in Pangaroa, that was Comvita, and you can read what they say there. You know, they are reusing, recycling, reselling 85% of their waste before we went in there. And then Trevelyans that I saw at the back there, they also went through our program, and you can read what they say. And then the top 10 holiday park in Hawaii Beach, he said that if they stopped recycling, look at what their waste bill would be. So it's really, really useful signing up for this. And we've been dealing with vets, with dentists, with shopping centres. We've done the Omokoroa Fresh Choice, a new centre out there, just showing people how to deal with their waste more effectively. Another one that we do is the Love Food Hate Waste campaign. That's nationwide that council has signed up to. And people always say, well, how can I make a difference to climate change? By not throwing your food away, okay? So if we toss our food away today, tomorrow the Earth's gonna chuck us away because we are really not looking after our resources. Look at the amount of food that we throw away in New Zealand. It's 122,000 tons. That's worth 870 million a year. So what do? We have to educate people. We educate people by having Love Food Hate Waste workshops and seminars. And look at that. You need to know what it is. When is something not safe to eat anymore? Use your common sense. Use your smell. A use-by date, don't eat it. But if it says best before, man, use your common sense. Supermarkets need to get it out, so have a bit of a look. And if you look at those listed, that's the things that we throw away in New Zealand the most. And think of ways how we can reuse that. And if you go on the Love Food Hate Waste website, you will find recipes for all of those wasted foods. So the way that you can make a difference is, I don't know who of you have been to one of Kate Mead's nappy lady classes where she got people to switch from disposable nappies to cloth nappies, but she's also doing waste-free living now. So those will be happening next year. The dates has not been set yet, so look at Council's website. And if you want to come to one of those waste-free living seminars, sign up. There's some ways that you can make a difference. Best of all is just use your head. Don't buy more than you need. And if you've got more, talk to your neighbours. Give some away. Another waste minimisation program that we run that's hugely successful is our worm composting workshop. We used to do that with Tauranga City a few years ago, where we sent a certain amount of Western Bay residents. But now we've got funding through the Waste Minimisation Fund, and we're putting on our own workshop. So the next one for Te Puke will be in February. But because your hall is being earthquakes tested and strengthened, it will be in Pangaroa. So as soon as we've got that date set in, it will be on the website and we'll advertise that. Come to the table over here if you want to come and have a look at a mini worm farm. I've dug it out this morning and I can show you what the worms look like. We also work with Marae in our district through the Parakori program. This is a program where they go on to Marae and they help Marae set up recycling systems. So that is one in Makatu where the health service got their certificates. They know how to sort their waste now. So you can read there that it's actually Māori working with Māori to reduce waste on Marae. So if you're interested in a program like that, this is the steps that will be taken through Parakori. Parakori started off with Jackie and Raglan. So they will basically come and you will sign them a memorandum of understanding. They will do a waste audit, and you saw in the previous slides what a waste audit is. And they will work you through all the steps to actually set up your marae or your medical centre or whatever to reduce the waste. So if you're interested in getting your marae involved, come and talk to me afterwards and I will pass that on to Parakore. So often we hear people say council needs to give more education. Now, I need to tell you now that we are already doing that. We've got zero waste education in almost all the schools in the Western Bay District. Preschools, primary, intermediate and college. So this is the group that actually does those programs for us. So come and have a chat to me if your school is not involved and you would like them to be. They have different segments that they deal with, the different age groups, and the one build each year on the other. So we are actually educating our younger people to do the right thing. Paper for Trees is another initiative that council supports. That is where schools and preschools sign up and all their waste paper gets collected, and at the end of the year we provide them with native plantings that they can then plant around their schools. So 42 of our schools in our district is already part of this initiative. You can read the success that we've got with it.